All right, so we're having a little bit of an air conditioning system problem today. Basically, we had a power outage yesterday, but the one thing we've noticed is that while the air conditioning system is running and it is cooling down the house, the fan never turns off in the air handler. I have everything shut off right now, and I'm going to go ahead and remove the thermostat, and we'll take a look at the fuse panel in just a second. All right, now that we're out here, and the thermostat is removed, when I turn this on, nothing should happen here because all the relays in the thermostat are no longer present, which means they're open. Nothing is closed, so nothing should enable the fan on the relay in here. However, that is just not the case, and that is not what's happening. So now what we have to check is the relay I replaced in here on a previous video. We're going to have to see if that relay is now permanently stuck closed, because that's the only reason that that circuit would be enabled, is if that relay is permanently in a closed position. Luckily, the relays that I replaced it with are labeled, so this should make this a lot easier. Let me go ahead though and get everything prepared by turning this off and putting the thermostat on it, so that way the AC will run at least for the time being and keep the house at least cool until I am all ready to proceed with this. All right, and now that everything is apart, let's go ahead and shut down the system. So the relay right there is what I've had to replace. And I can already tell you something looks smoked. Looks like we have a smoke transistor there. Ooh, something else. Oh boy. So we got some work ahead here. Let's go ahead and disconnect everything and see what we can salvage. If anything, I might not even have the right parts. Oh boy. Yeah, that's definitely not looking too good. So what we see here, the relay has blown a hole right out of its ass, and so did the transistor, and a few of these components have apparently gotten smoked. So now I have to do some of the repair and remove the relay, remove the transistor. I have the transistor right here, and I have a new relay right here, but these parts, it almost looks like it's going to be, you know what, it may not be as bad as it looks, because that's right in the path of the hole where the relay is, and I'm thinking that might just be stuff that blew out of the relay and smoked these parts, but they may not be damaged. So, but I do want to replace the transistor for one. And I do want to replace the relay. I don't know if the transistor got damaged, but the coloration that I'm seeing on it, like I said, could have been from here, but who knows what damage that had. So we'll take a look at that. We'll take this one at a time. After cleaning everything with the Q-tip, it looks like all these components are actually fine. The relay itself may even be perfectly fine. It doesn't really, I mean, it looks a little charred, but I think it was only charred because of what happened to the relay here. So what I'm going to try to do is replace only the relay, not bother with anything else, and then plop it in and see if it works exactly as it should. Meaning, when I turn on the air handler, the fan should not turn on automatically. It should have a delay until when the thermostat says it's ready to turn the fan on. But let's go ahead and unsolder this and replace that relay. All right, well, here we go. Here we are. We have the board here sitting on my table, ready to be dismantled, or at least to have the relay removed. But what I want to show you why the air handler is stuck on is because the relay is permanently closed. When it burnt out. As you see here, this is a good relay. Power from the mains comes in on this pin right here. And what happens is, when the relay is sitting idle, there's a
piece in here that will move back and forth based on how the relay is energized. And you can actually see right here on the diagram exactly where it sits when idle and where it will move when it's energized. So basically, when it's sitting off and not powered, power goes through from this pin directly over to this pin. And I can show that with a continuity test right here. See? In the other pin, nothing. But I'm betting you, if I test it between the pin and its on state, it's gonna beep over here. Yep. And you see the, oh, that's even worse. This relay is so badly damaged, it's got power between its off and its on state. That can actually damage the motor because you see both of them actually go to different pads out here. You got your not connected, or normally closed, normally open, and your common. So that's not good. That hopefully didn't cause any more damage to the blower itself or the other components. I'm pretty certain it probably didn't, otherwise the motor wouldn't be running. But I do believe this is the difference between heat and cold, and based on how it commands the blower motor to operate, you know, slower speed and a higher speed. Being that it's running at all, chances are it's probably fine. But that's not good. That relay really shorted out. So these two pins are shorted. So yeah, this relay, it's gotta go. And I got my solder sucker here, and let's do this. Let's get this relay out of here. Now I'm trying to think how this could have happened. My theory is when we had a power outage, maybe it took out only a certain phase of power. You know, maybe it was a, I don't know how the air handler runs, if it runs on multiple phases or not. I don't think it does. It doesn't seem to over here, but who knows? There wasn't a power surge, so I can't blame power surges. So I'm not too certain what happened there. And the house is getting hotter, which is why I have my beer with me. It's the only thing that's going to keep me cold. The other thing too that really bothers me is I've had to repair this board now twice. This board couldn't be that well designed if you have to make multiple repairs like this. And both times it seems that it happened after a power outage. I've checked the electric to the house and everything there is perfectly fine, so I'm not too certain why this just keeps happening. It's just crap design, honestly. All right, this relay is already removed. That's all there was to this. And now for the new relay. I'm not gonna do much on cleaning up because the traces are just so far apart. I mean, I could just wipe it down and everything's fine. Nothing will be shorting out. So let me go ahead and put this new relay in its place. There we go. And I'm going to solder that. I'm going to start with two points from each other. This is usually how you want to do this kind of stuff anyway. You know, that way you can tack it down and then get the rest. So I'm going to start with this big pad. This is the common. This is where it gets its common power. Probably a ground. I don't think this is a... I don't think this is DC. I was almost pretty certain it was AC. The motor runs on alternating current. I'm not too certain. I haven't really checked into that. Okay, let's go ahead and tack this little part down. Okay. There we go. Now it's flowing there. Come on. Now, it is bubbling up, and I usually prefer not to have the solder bubble up like that, but there is so much current going through here that I don't think it's going to really be much of an issue. Because I do want it to go through all the way, also. And actually, the original relay was soldered just like that. So, who knows? Maybe that's how it was just intended to be done. I don't know. So, soldering is all done. The only thing left at this point is to check it out and see if it works. So, let me make sure this is dried up first. Good. And I'm going to check it again, make sure there's no shorts. There shouldn't be because there's really nothing between it. Alright. And it should only beep with on here, but not here. Perfect. It beeped only where it should. Now, we'll go ahead and plug this board back into the air handler and see if it works exactly as it's supposed to. The board is put back into the air handler. I'm very nervous and hope it doesn't blow up the relay again. So, I'm going to go ahead and turn it on, and if everything works, this motor should not turn on right away. And it didn't. I hear power. So now we're sitting in here, waiting for cool on to engage. And basically once cool on turns on, it'll kick on the compressor outside, and then within a few, I think it's like 30 seconds or 15 seconds, the fan should engage. And that's when those electronics get powered up. So far, so good. All right, it has turned its system on. I can actually hear the flowing of the Freon already. And let's see if the fan kicks on. Usually takes it around 30 seconds. There it goes! Looks like we are all fixed!